Hey everybody, Carl here. So you want a fuel line that's able to hold up to corrosive materials like today's oxygenated pump fuels better than a rubber line braided hose. A polytetrafluoroethylene or PTFE braided line might be just what you're looking for, but you need to know how to assemble one. PTFE braided lines have a different core material and a three-piece fitting rather than a two-piece fitting used on the rubber line braided hose. The third fitting in a PTFE braided line is a compression fitting, sometimes called an olive or a ferrule, which helps hold everything together, but adds a small layer of complexity to the assembling of your PTFE braided line. Let's start this job like any other by assembling the tools we'll need. We suggest a vise to make sure the fittings don't rotate while assembling them, duct tape, both an AN fitting wrench and an adjustable wrench, a hose cutter, and a small screwdriver or pick. Once your tools are assembled, choose the size and length of braided line you will need. Measure and wrap the line in duct tape and mark where you plan to make your cut. This will help the steel braided line from fraying. The line will be very sharp. Using duct tape will help prevent it from poking you. Make your cut on the mark. Remove the duct tape and slide the fitting nut over the tubing. Once you have the nut in place, you can use your screwdriver to pull the braided line away from the PTFE tubing. Make sure you pull back enough of the steel braided line so the compression nut fits securely. You'll see a lip on the top, which the PTFE tubing should contact. The compression nut will fit over the PTFE tubing and under the steel braided line for a secure fit. When you have the compression nut in place, secure the nut and a vise to tighten the AN fitting. You can use duct tape on the fitting to prevent marring when using an adjustable wrench. Now you're ready to go with your new custom fit PTFE braided line. That's all I have for today. Thanks for watching.